Hi friends, I am CA MS Mehta, making Excel easy for you. Today we'll be talking about the function subtotal. If you are passionate about learning Excel, subscribe to my channel below and click on the bell icon. How many times you face a challenge where we have a sum at one place of all the sales which is there, and then we filter the data, but the sum remains the same, it doesn't change. Or let's take a second illustration. We have here fixed assets which contains multiple subtotals using the sum function. But when we want a grand total, if we use the function sum, we'll be double counting. How about if I tell you there's a wonderful function subtotal to make our job easier? There are two major benefits of subtotal. First, you can perform dynamic calculations. Second, it ignores the subtotals which are within the range selected without having to worry about double counting. Let's see how it works. Now the subtotal takes two main arguments. One is the function you wish to perform, and the second is the range. Now since mostly I use sum, which in this case is number 9, so I've kind of a crammed the number through whenever I want to sum it. Though you can use any of it, you can use average, you can use count or any of this. Let's write the formula. So I'll start with a function, which in this case is function 9, which means a sum. And then I'll put the range, which I've already named as sales. That's about it. What we have is total, which is matching the sum function. Now, if you were to filter the data set down to a select set of data points, for example, Earth Limited, if I just filter it, you'll see that the subtotal function will calculate sum of only the data points that are selected. This thus helps perform these functions very dynamically. Similarly, we could have it for average, for count, for any of these different functions. Let's take another example. Here we have a list of some assets in some categories. Typically, we'll be using sum function for all these categories. And when I want a grand total, B26 plus B31 plus B38, which is cumbersome, and more so if some more categories are introduced, then this total doesn't update automatically. So rather than using sum, I'll be using subtotal. Again, since I'm using sum, I'll be using the function 9. Parenthesis close. Similarly, again subtotal 9 and the range. One more subtotal 9 and the range. We are using 9 because we are summing the whole thing. Now, when I want a grand total, I'll again use the function subtotal 9. Now, range in this case I'll take is the whole one, right from here till the top. And what we have is a subtotal, a sum which ignores all these different subtotals. So the beauty of subtotal is that it ignores subtotal in the range. Don't you think you can save tons of time with this one feature? Let me know in the comments below. Now friends, there's also a feature subtotal in the data tab, which we'll explore in the next video. If you like this video, give a thumbs up. Subscribe now to learn more about these kind of Excel hacks. Thanks for watching. Meet you in the next episode.